This is the story of Ultimate Frisbee at St. George's. But before we look at St. George's, we must look back at how the sport of Ultimate Frisbee got started. Ultimate Frisbee started in 1968 when the first game was played by a group of students at Columbia High School in Maplewood, New Jersey. The next big step for Ultimate was in 1972 when the first college game was played between Rutgers and Princeton. Throughout the 70s and 80s, Ultimate proliferated in both the college and club ranks around the country, especially in the Northeast and in California. It has continued to grow all around the world. College Ultimate is extremely competitive, with over 800 colleges fielding teams. A major step came in 2012 when a pro league, the American Ultimate Disc Association, was founded. Ultimate is considered to be one of the fastest growing sports in the world. Now, back to St. George's. The origins of Ultimate Frisbee at St. George's can be traced back to Kyle Slattery in 2012.
The first time we started playing Ultimate was the summer after my first year. So I think that was the summer of 2012. And I did it as a way to stay connected with a lot of the lacrosse players at school, as a way for them to come.
The Ultimate Club was founded in 2015 by Jared Whitaker, Connor Funk, and Winston Margaritas. That same year brought a fresh-faced chemistry teacher from Los Angeles, California, named Ethan Sullivan.
So I first got here in the fall of 2015, and one of my students, Winston Margaritas, told me he could throw a better backhand, I believe, than I could, and I told him that was not true. And one thing led to another. We started having pickup games on Fridays, and a pretty good portion at that point of the 10th grade class came out and played, and you know, we just kind of built momentum from there.
Ultimate quickly took off, and people's perceptions of it changed dramatically once they started playing.
Bart Muller, I've been part of the Ultimate Club for 2 years now. And honestly, you think of Ultimate Frisbee without, you know, being a part of it. You think of a bunch of college guys on the lawn at their college, like, you know, taking it way too seriously, like getting angry, and it's honestly, it's not a negative connotation, but you know, a lot of people don't really buy into it because of that. But after having experienced it and been able to play it with my friends and really take the time to learn the game, I think honestly it's been a complete U-turn for my opinion of it. I think it's one of my favorite things to do, and it's one of the best games that I've ever played.
Ultimate, before I started playing here, was a...
See, that is what you don't want to do.
A sport for beach bums who didn't really have anything else to do in their spare time and decided they're going to go get a Frisbee, which children play with, and throw it around. And after I started playing it, I realized this is a sport that combines, you know, all aspects of athleticism. You know, it's such a mashup of all these different things into one sport that, you know, it gives leeway for everybody to participate in it. And you can't really say that about a lot of other sports.
I mean, before sophomore year, junior year, no one was playing Ultimate. Like, you wouldn't see anybody playing Ultimate. You might see one or two people, like, hucking the disc with Mr. Ferguson in middle school recess, but that was it. But now, you know, as a senior, you come back from lunch and you see, like, 20, 30 guys all playing Frisbee every single day in the grass in front of school. And it just goes to show that the game has gone from almost nothing to, like, one of the most popular extracurriculars at our school.
Sort of Ultimate 2.0, more than just, how it started, which is exciting. But I think at the same time, it's kept its inclusive qualities of wanting to encourage as many kids to come out and play as possible. It hasn't grown into a beast that is beyond, you know, I think its essence. That is, it's a fun game. It's a game that, you know, includes everyone, boys and girls, middle schoolers, upper schoolers. So it's kept its, I think, heart and soul. And at the same time, it's grown too, which is really cool. It's more than what it was, but it still retains, I guess, in a lot of ways, the spirit of what it started out being, which is really cool.
A typical game of Friday Ultimate looks something like this.
Something that was brand new to me with coming into St. George's. I'd never really consistently thrown a Frisbee, maybe every now and then at the beach or something like that. But Ultimate has brought me together with so many different people in different ways, competitively, friendly. Ultimate has given me the opportunity to hang out with guys that I wouldn't get a chance to be around, such as, you know, maybe some underclassmen who are on my team when I'm playing on Friday afternoons, or even in the spring who are on the team also. It's provided so many different opportunities for tournaments and cardio, even just like a cardio workout after school on a Friday afternoon, or all the way to bringing me to much closer to guys who I think are really good people and I enjoy being around. So without Ultimate, I don't think some of those relationships would be possible.
The next major step for the Ultimate program was the creation of a St. George's competitive club team named Nirvana in the spring of 2017. Coached by Ethan Sullivan, Nirvana competed in the Memphis City High School Ultimate League and won the 2017 City Championship.
1, 2, 3, Nirvana!
You know, it started from four guys standing out in the lawn and just throwing a Frisbee around in the circle to, you know, an actual team with strategy and, you know, team spirit, a sense of, like, you know, brotherhood. Like, it's kind of amazing because you don't get to see that in a lot of schools, like a sport slowly start to form, you know. Baseball will always be there from the beginning, football and programs are always there from the beginning, but, you know, Ultimate, it's a new thing and you get to see it sprout up, and I think that's a really cool thing to witness.
What's your favorite play you've ever made during Ultimate?
Favorite play has to be last year during the season against Arlington. Huge game. They were the other best team that we ever played during the season. And we were receiving the disc, and as soon as they threw it off to us, I decided I was going deep. So I decided to start sprinting down the field as fast as I can, and the defender had no chance. I burnt him. And Winston, he recognized this, and he just hucked it deep, and it was the best point I've ever scored in my entire life. Best feeling in the world.
Get on it! Don't jump!
And then we can get him over.
Go first stroke! Get on it!
Hey!
Get board!
One of the standout players on Nirvana is Griffin Hancock.
He's just a really great athlete. He's really quick and he's fast.
Unfortunately, over the years I've had to find myself on the other side of the disc trying to defend Griffin, which is pretty much an impossible task. But on this particular play...
Another Nirvana standout, Graham Sisson, continued to play Ultimate at the next level at Dartmouth College.
Haven't played varsity sports all through high school. Ultimate was always just kind of one of those things I really like to do. I like to play pickup. I like to like throw the Frisbee around out in front of school. And really just always like to do that. But then with Nirvana, my senior spring, it was a really cool opportunity to be able to do, like actually play on a real team on top of baseball and all the other stuff going on. And it was the perfect perfect level and balance of like seriousness, like being on a real team, like actually really caring and wanting to win our games, but at the same time just throwing the Frisbee around with the guys and really just having a good time, but at the same time like actually ended up winning a championship. So it was a huge part of my senior spring for sure. And so I ended up just, you know, trying out for the team because I met a few of the guys throwing the Frisbee around on the green. And that first week, decided to try out for the team. Ended up making the A-team pain train. And since then, I've learned so much. There's so much more to the game of Ultimate than the pickup that I've always played up until somewhat Nirvana and then really this year. And even though I'd always, like, kind of see myself as, you know, like, kind of getting the basics of the game, there is so much that I'm still learning, even now, like, 6 months in. And having played on Nirvana was a huge part of that transition, making that transition manageable. But it really, even then, it's just really a stepping stone for the things you can end up doing in college.
Nirvana coach and Ultimate Club sponsor Mr. Sullivan has had the ultimate impact on students at St. George's, both on the Frisbee field and in the classroom.
Review the relationship between the temperature of gases and the particle velocities, right, and the temperature of gases and how much energy they have.
Mr. Sullivan has, I've had him since I was a sophomore in his regular chemistry, and then I had him junior year playing Ultimate and AP chemistry, and honestly he's been a role model to me, and just his approach to everything is just so like calm, cool, and collected. He almost never raises his voice or gets mad. He's always direct, to the point, reasonable, and he's just someone you can really model yourself off, you know, in life.
Mr./Ethan/Coach Sullivan has impacted me in so many different ways, from being just kind of the guy that I go and talk to throughout the day at school when either something goes well, something goes wrong, we're just talking about baseball stats or Frisbee in general. Mr. Sullivan has been someone who I really look up to. Just the way he goes about his business, kind of how he carries himself, kind of what he's done for me as a young man. You know, I've learned and talked about so many different life lessons with him, and at the same time we get to share the Frisbee on the field. So it's interesting because he has a much different personality than I do. So it's great to see the way that me and him interact while we're in a real game in the spring. Sometimes we can kind of butt heads, but in a way I think it's a really positive relationship, and I'm forever thankful for what he's done for me.
You know, I think the program has kind of centered around him. He's a very, you know, you can see, you know, the kids around Mr. Sullivan, just kind of, there's a spark there. He's fun. He's got a great demeanor. He's fun to play with. He's always encouraging.
Kind of guy in a lot of ways, but also he's one of the most intelligent people that I know. And when you talk to him, you know, a lot of times you don't expect to get that deep into a conversation with him, but you'll start talking about one thing and you'll end up talking about like some book that he read in high school that he thinks is one of the greatest of all time, and he'll recommend it to you. And it just goes to show that he can relax and be chill, or also he can hold an intelligent conversation with anybody. So he's just kind of amazing in that regard. Beautiful mind.
Like, I haven't seen a teacher who is so, you know, involved with students in a way that's made like such an impact on who they are as like people. You know, by introducing Ultimate Frisbee at St. George's, you know, he brought together a group of people who normally wouldn't cross paths socially all the time. You know, personally for me, he's helped me make a lot of friends, and I've become close friends with him. I consider him somewhat of a mentor. You know, he's taught me, you know, I never participated in like any sport whatsoever until it came to Ultimate Frisbee, and it taught me a lot. he taught me a lot about what it means to be in a team, working together with people, you know, knowing that somebody will have your back. You know, that's something, you know, you got to value in a person in life, and Sullivan exemplifies that in every way.
Yeah, well, I think Mr. Sullivan was kind of like the classic St. George's teacher experience where, like, yeah, he was my AP Chem teacher, so we had a lot of, like, in-class time together, struggling through stuff. Like, I'm not sure I still entirely understand, but he was my friend, too, and I feel pretty comfortable saying that. And that was a big part of that is Ultimate, was because of Ultimate. Just everything from throwing around on out in front of school to actually then playing the games and actually having him as a real coach, it really just... It made me realize that, you know, he's a lot more than just a teacher. We were, like, actually friends, and we could... And then that helped our relationship both in the classroom and outside of the classroom, and ultimately ended up being one of the most impactful people in my life at St. George's.
The future of the Ultimate program lies with rising senior Will Johns.
How do you feel about taking over leadership of the Ultimate program next year?
I'm really excited to take over next year. Like, we're obviously going to be losing a lot of key seniors, and we have to fill those voids. I have some names already in my head that I could think could step up big time next year and fill in those roles. And I'm really excited just to lead the guys. Learned a lot from Winston and Sullivan. I think I'm ready. And we'll have a great group of seniors as well next year to lead. I think with a bunch of new guys, I think we'll be real good.